Hey, check out this old footage. This is 3-foot narrow gauge railroad. This is the Georgetown Loop Railroad in Denver, Colorado. Look at this. It even has sound. This is some cool footage. It's a center cab switcher. And he's going to stop. Now, look at the conductor, how he's dressed back then. And he's going to line the switch behind him. And wouldn't it be cool to see like what this looks like in May of 2023, like I did when I flew out to Denver. I rented a car and went 40 miles out to the Georgetown Loop Railroad. So hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. You're gonna love this whole video. Man, like going from Pittsburgh to the Rocky Mountains, driving through it just to see this, you're gonna love this. Just came over one mountain. It's just green, and now I'm seeing snow-capped mountains. Wow. This is so nuts. Never driven through anything like this. Look at this. Crazy. So my trip started at the Devil's Gate. We loop around ourselves, we go up a 4% grade, and all the way up to Silver Plume and back. It's about an hour and 15 minute run. And it's some beautiful scenery. So I got my coach pass.
There you go.
How you doing?
Keep following up, thank you.
James. And I found myself a coach car. They had both the open cars and the closed cars. There's a lot of familiar faces on this trip. A lot of other YouTubers were there.
I miss this guy all the time.
My friends Barky and Michelle.
Awesome! That's so cool.
He's a kid.
Hi!
So this was my first time in the Rocky Mountains. And now I see why it's named that. If you like that, wait till you see future videos where I show you a fantastic model railroad. It looks just like it, just like the Rocky Mountains. So on our way up the mountain, we have to do a complete loop. And I'm gonna tell you, this guy, he did a great job telling us like what to expect. What's on both sides of the tracks, the history, and there's so much history. There's so much. I'm not going to do a whole history lesson. You can just Google that yourselves. But he kept us entertained pretty much the whole trip with both information and some comedy.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am very sorry for the interruption. However, I do have to say that if there's anyone on board the train that doesn't have a ticket, this is the part of the ride where I need you to get off of my train.
Hey, check out that old turntable. There used to be a turntable back in the day, then they used that for a bridge, and now it's just set aside. A lot of cool stuff. and we're going to be getting off at the Silver Plume station. We've got about 10 minutes to walk around.
This is not the mine tour stop. So if you do want to get that mine tour, I recommend you get back on board this train before transporting. With that, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Silver Plume, Colorado, elevation 9,178 feet above sea level.
This was so cool, and I had a beautiful weather up here too. Look at all this stuff. Now, it's hard to remember that, look at the gauge. It's only 3 foot gauge. It's not your standard, 4 foot, 8.5 inches. This is all narrow gauge. Narrow gauge was just ideal for tight curves and for this terrain. Now, I'll tell you as an engineer, if we have a set route, we will come up one track, cut away, line our switch, go back the other way, and then the conductor does go back and line our switch for the original movement. That way, the next day, we can do it again, and the switch will be lined for us. So that's why he's going back and lining the switch behind him. Look at the water tower back there for the steam engines. Now, center caps, you're probably thinking they can go either way, the way is the front, but technically every engine does have a front. In this case, he is going backwards, hence the three toots for reverse movement. A lot of cool stuff to see up at Silver Plume. Wish we had a little bit more time. We had a few minutes. Just a quick stretch of the legs. Take a few pictures. Look at the steam engines in the back. How cool is this place? So much fun. There's so many engines up here. And there's, like I said, there's a really good backstory of the different railroads. This video is just going to be showing you some of the cool sights that I saw and really try to give you an idea of what the Rocky Mountains really, they're breathtaking. You don't realize it until you go out and you see it for yourself. You're like, wow. It was neat seeing a lot of the Denver and Rio Grande stuff. And the engineering of a curved bridge on a grade.
Both a curve and a grade. The engineering practices of the time simply said it couldn't be done. However, defying all of the odds, the Double Deep Iron Bridge was the first iron railroad bridge in the entire world to accomplish growth. So, the bridge lies on a 19.5-degree curve, and although it might look level, it's actually on a grade of 10%. This means the side that we just entered on is 6 feet higher than the side we're exiting on. Back when the bridge was being built in 1883 and 1884, they actually took them 3 separate attempts to build it. The first time the bridge was completed in September of 1883, they discovered to their horror that the entire bridge was built backwards. So the whole thing had to be deconstructed and rebuilt, which ended up being a 3-month job at the start of winter.
So I have more videos coming from my trip out to Denver. Show you some great model railroading, railroad museums, and more. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, DJ's Trains, please do so. And you can follow me on Facebook and Instagram under DJ's Trains, my Patreon site if you want to do Zoom calls, and there's other perks to it. I got so much good stuff coming, so thank you guys for watching, and I will see you Did you notice that I put my logo there? I don't know if you saw that or not. So I will see you in the next video. Like I said, so much footage. So please subscribe.